Hi, you guys. I've moved over to Post 8. Here's why. This is where CBS is among other stocks that trades right here, but CBS is in the news right now. Right now, it's down 0.75%, but earlier around 12:40, CBS traded at a 52-week high, or actually, it was a nearly 2.5-year high. It had spiked. And here's what's gyrating the stock right now. How about the CEO of the media giant, the man who slayed the Redstones by telling them either I'm in charge or no deal? But looks like Sherry and Sumner Redstone heard him loud and clear after they called off the potential merger between the company they control, that's Viacom, and CBS. I want to bring in Charlie Gasparino because he's got more details on something you and I, Charlie, have been talking about for months and months here. But Les is sort of that first person who stood up to the Redstones and apparently is living to tell, at least for now.
Well, because of a massive golden parachute, if he should leave. We should point out, give viewers a little perspective here. National Amusements, which is the holding company that holds both CBS, run by Sumner Redstone, and Viacom, which was run until fairly recently by Philippe Dumont. Sherry Redstone, now who controls this big conglomerate, would like to merge those two publicly traded companies into one. Now, today she announced she's not going that way. That's why you see the gyrations on the stock. The question is why, after she wanted to do it. And it comes down to one person. It's the person that we flagged to viewers for months now. I went back and looked at the tape. You know, a couple of months ago, you and I reported point blank that Sumner Redstone, that Les Moonves was skeptical about the deal. He was worried that if you combine the two companies, that would crush CBS's valuations and hurt his legacy as a CEO. And he had the chops, particularly in a contract, to sort of block it, at least to tell Sherry that he's about to walk if she does this. And from what I understand, that's more or less what happened. Sherry Redstone theoretically is his boss, but if Les Moonves walks out and he's one of the better CEOs in corporate America, at least according to stock performance right now, he gets paid, from what I understand, a very hefty sum of money, well north of $100 million in a golden parachute. That is something they didn't want to fret with right now. And I guess part of this dance, and if you notice, the stock is going back and forth now. You said CBS was, you know, spiked and now it's come back down. One of the reasons why it came back down is because there's still room for negotiation here. My guess is Moonves wants some say on the National Amusements board. At least that's what we heard in the past that he wanted. And when they grant him that, that's when you see some of this merger can come back where he agrees to it. But he's going to want his pound of flesh, from what I understand. And he has got the contract to walk away and live a very comfortable life with them paying him a lot of money and making them look pretty dumb because he's a good CEO if they don't give him what he wants. So that's where we are right now. I would say this is an impasse right now. If you notice, that's a crazy stock. That's a crazy chart in CBS.
Yeah,
it went down and then back up.
I can show you, Charlie. Let me show you at the Post here. We got about 15.9 million shares trading, down 0.2%. When it's green, it's just that it's up off the lows there. But really important to point out, again, that it had hit that 2.5-year high earlier today at about 12:40. So I'm finding this a fascinating stock behavior. But we chose to put Viacom on the lower part of people's screens so that they can see that's really getting hammered. They got to figure something out better content.
I mean, listen, I think, you know, they do. I mean, listen, there's a problem there. There's a reason why Philippe Dumont was at the top of the world 3 years ago, and he's not now. And a lot of it's programming. A lot of it's out of his control. People are cutting cords. We should point out that Gary Cohn did just get brought on to the number two guy at Goldman Sachs as Trump's head of the NEC. Two interesting stories here. It's a story inside Goldman. I can tell you this is going to be a management change. On foxbusiness.com, you can read my latest on who's probably going to be the heir apparent to the CEO, Lloyd Blankfein. But also Blankfein, from what I hear, is very relieved that Cohn is finally gone. He's been pushing for this, pushing to be number one for a long time. And one other thing I will tell you, there are a lot of annoyed supply-siders out there that Larry Kudlow did not get this job. He was up for it, and instead, President-elect Donald Trump picked someone who, let's be real clear here, Gary Cohn is an Obama-supporting liberal, and he picked him over a supply-sider. That's something that's going to get supply-siders very, very angry. Okay. That's going to be a story going forward.
Well, you know what? Everything's up for grabs at this point. What he said during the campaign, different from what he's doing right now.
Absolutely.
Charlie Gasparino, thank you so much.